Hello, 9th grade children. This is your first history class. Yes, the first lesson, evolution of humans and society in prehistoric period. I welcome you all to this e-learning platform. Welcome. Evolution of humans and society, prehistoric period. We'll go to the first slide. Origin of the earth and the geological ages. History of human beings is almost closely related to the origin of the earth. Okay, almost, not exactly in the sense, but still almost it's closely related to the origin of the earth. Okay, understand that clearly. So the history of humans is closely related to the earth. Earth in the sense, earth origin is there, but after centuries maybe, still humans have been started living on the earth. So human age is not a lesser time period, but it's almost closely to the origin of the earth. Now the earth contains geological, archaeological and biological records of historical time in its upper layers. How do you find out this time period? How is it able for the scientists or the archaeologists to find out what is the time period of a particular creature or a time period of a human being or something like that? Yes, so how they are finding is, we are based on geological. Geological is earth, rocks, crust, soil, that volcano eruptions, everything from there, they will be collecting all the data. And this archaeology is remainings, that is previous people or the animals who lived before us, centuries before, they'll be leaving something behind them. Maybe they are, if human beings means they are things, what they are using, that is materials, anything maybe. Okay, maybe a human, maybe an animal. For example, I have heard when I was young that in the Antarctic continent and all, in the snow, that mammoth was being preserved carefully, that is carefully in the sense completely in that ice. And even after centuries, that people who study archaeology, that is archaeologists, were able to find out and identify that there was a creature called mammoth and it was living and it was existing on the earth centuries before. Like that, so archaeology also helps us or gives data accordingly. And even biological in the sense, we have DNAs, we take DNA samples, we take various other things like collect data through DNAs to understand generations, how before generations, what were the diseases, what were the situation, how people were there, what sort of character were there, what sort of creativity were there, everything, they were able to identify such biological records also. So these help us to identify about the people in the prehistoric age. So this lesson teaches us what about how the people were there, what are the situation, how we were able to find out the data, like that they are covering in this lesson. They are important for reconstructing the history of the earth and various living organism. We are living in a technological era. Okay, everything, each and every moment we are getting everything in our hands through mobile, through television, through internet, through everything, so many devices and technologies are there. But still, people in the prehistoric age, they were not like that. They were having completely a rural setup, completely a different kind of a setup, which we cannot think about it. They were the forefathers who were starting creatively, and because of their creativity, we have landed in this technological era. So we should understand how they were living, how they started to discover, for example, fire, wheel, everything and all, and how they started to do that, what was the circumstance leading for such a creativity. So that all we learned through these lessons. Okay, so they are important for reconstructing the history of the earth and various living organisms. How what kind of organisms were there? Now dinosaurs are not there in the present era, but dinosaurs were existing, was in the earth history, you all know maybe. So that all we are learning through data, so that will be covered through these lessons and history. The next slide, you can see archaeologists are excavating under the earth through these, that is they'll be collecting the coins, that mud materials, that clay artifacts, everything there will be. That sometimes statues are being found out. Sometimes a whole city will be under the earth ground like that. They have been able to find out through these, and they collect data through that. What is the origin? Which century was it? Who was the king? Who was the ruler? Everything they'll be covering under this through this excavation process. Okay. So now let's see. Few terms have been dealt in this lesson in the first part of the introduction. Let's see. Paleoanthropologists and archaeologists excavate the soil and rock layers of the earth and extract evidence about human ancestors. So I already said they are collecting certain things, and please learn these spellings of these terms. Okay. In the next slide, I'll be explaining what is this. Okay. Paleoanthropologist. Just divide this word, split the word, and you can read it. Paleoanthropologist. Okay. From the animals, from the excavation, from the remaining parts, they will be finding out the data. Even if you get a small piece of a bone, through carbon dating, they will find out in which time period was this particular organism was existing. And the DNA and the biological factors present in that piece of bone, they'll identify which organism also. Like that, so much of technology and science has been improved nowadays. So through this, an archaeologist from the remainings of the materials used by the humans. Okay. So through that, they'll excavate the soil. Excavate means digging under the ground, and they will be finding out. If anything they'll get, they will find out, they will discover what it is, and they will give out the data for us. So excavate the soil and rock layers. Sometimes some fossils are being embedded in the soil. Embedded in the soil means fixed in the soil. You can see it in the rocks also. So they'll be carefully, minutely, they'll be working. They'll not just take a big spade and they'll be digging the under the earth. Very minutely they'll be scraping, and they'll be doing it, finding out, because there's not a single piece of data should be lost. Okay. If they get a small thing, it will be a greater record for the history. So like that, they'll be excavating about human ancestors. Ancestors are forefathers or people who lived before us. These layers and fossils are scientifically dated to study the various stages in human evolution and history. Later you will be learning all the stages of the history, like prehistory, Iron Age, rulers, that is stages of rulers, each rulers who were ruling in the society, in the history. Everything we'll be learning in the later part of the history. Next slide. You can see in the picture how they are doing it. Yes, this is a kind of a statue. They have got it. They are not just pulling it up like that. Yes, they are just gently brushing it. They are making it, scraping it. They are neatly taking it out, and they are doing it. Okay. So archaeology is the study of human past through the analysis and interpretation of material remains. So a person who studies or deals with this branch of called archaeology is called as archaeologist. Okay. So archaeology is the study of human past through the analysis and interpretation of material remains. I said, no, this is the material remains. That is whatever we are using it. Today I may be using a brass pot. Later some years, sometimes it may be under the earth. People after our years or after our centuries, whoever comes, when they do this excavation, they may get it and they will find out, okay, they were living in the century called 2020, 2021, around that centuries they were living. And people were having such a lifestyle, they were having such a kind of a clothing, they're having food habits, everything they'll be finding out through such material remains. That is called archaeology. Okay. Now, paleoanthropology, the previous slide we saw it, is the study of human ancestors and their evolution by the study of fossil remains. Fossil, you all know, the remainings of remainings of an animal or a human being. Remainings of animal or human beings, body part, bones, yes, things like that. Now, you all know human beings have evolved from the, apes, yes, a kind of a monkey. Yes, that's what they are saying. We have been evolved from the apes. Humans are evolved from the apes. You can see it in the picture, it's been depicted there. Yes, so that's what studying about that, studying the human remains and the fossils is called as the paleoanthropology, and the person who studies about this, paleoanthropologist. Okay, so that's the thing. Next slide. The earth was formed approximately, we cannot definitely you can say this is the exact time period, no, but 4.54 billion years ago, gradually plants and animals, that too not of a sudden, gradually some chemical changes happen and plants and animals evolved, and the humans also evolved from the monkeys, that is apes. Then the long span of time in the history of earth is divided into eras. Later what we did is, in order to study easily or to identify easily, to understand easily, they divide the human evolution into eras, periods and epochs. Okay, by the geologists. Geologists in the sense, those who study about the earth and the earth crust is called geologists. Okay, and the measurement, 1 billion is equal to 100 crore, 1 million is equal to 10 lakh. The next slide, you can see your beautiful picture of your forefather. Yes, you can see Australopithecians, apes from which humans evolved. They believe that, or Charles Darwin has said that, humans have evolved from the apes. So, because almost all the features of an ape is resembling, and the DNA, everything is resembling with a human being. So, Charles Darwin has noted down that we have been evolved from the apes, and that study is called as Australopithecians. Okay. Now, they are extinct and considered close relatives to human beings. You cannot see such apes now because we have come from them, so they have gone. They have been extinct. Please learn this word, extinct. Extinct means no more. Okay, so now they are extinct, but they are the forefathers, or we are their close relatives to us, like that. History says about it. Hope you all understood the introductory part of the first lesson one in history. Yes, read well and study well. Thank you. Have a nice day.